People of all ages were on hand at Bristol Boat Company for good food and drinks, good conversation, and to get their first look at the new Herreshoff 20.
Curious, how many hours do you think into the boat?
Actually doing the prototype, which I've done essentially single-handed for the past year, about 2,000 hours.
2,000.
Originally designed by Captain Nat Herreshoff back in 1929, the Herreshoff 20 was never actually built until now.
That is gorgeous.
My name is Peter Sterrett. My partner here, Peter Brewster, from Herreshoff Yacht Sales. I get to introduce my boss, Halsey Herreshoff. It's just very exciting to be involved with the Herreshoff and this project, and gives me great pleasure to introduce to you Halsey Herreshoff. Halsey.
Well, thank you very much, Peter, and I'm so pleased working with both you and Peter Brewster. So when we come in and say, where's Peter? They have to figure out which one we mean. Great partners in what we're doing. And of course, I beckoned Adam Langman to come up here, but he won't do it. But Adam and I have been designing boats for several years, and it's such a pleasure working with somebody as able as Adam is. We both graduated from the same college, Webb Institute of Naval Architecture, which is America's finest school of naval architecture. But I graduated before he did. But of all the projects we've done, this is the most fascinating and certainly a very promising one. And to have Dan Shea set up this magnificent shop and to start a production line, here's the number two boat ready to be molded here. And I'm hoping it'll be like Henry Ford's line where these will go here and out the door. And to work with him and observe and appreciate his sense of perfection and his desire to follow the techniques of my grandfather, Nat Herreshoff, and his admiration of the lines is all gelled together to this project. And I think you're all sharing with me satisfaction in the way this boat looks. Dan's technique, which he's going to tell you a little more about in a minute, is, I think, a wonderful wedding of the values of the old construction together with employment of modern adhesives and finishes and modern methods. And this molding of a hull surface with thin wood going in different directions and using the vacuum, which is a huge force. See, one of the problems in gluing together convex surfaces is that it's very difficult to get the different layers to press together each other. You can use a lot of fastenings, but put a fastening here and it may blow up in between. But using the force of vacuum is a huge force, and he's got that technique worked out. So I think that what I'd like to do is ask Dan, who's the real star of the moment here, to speak to you and tell you more about it, and then I might make a couple more remarks at the end. And maybe I can get Adam to make some remarks.
Halsey, everyone. My wife, my family, my compatriots, and especially our Burnside Street community, our Bristol Boat Building community, and the boat building and business community in Rhode Island, thank you so much for being here. I'd like to be able to say this is just another day at the boat shop. However, the last time I looked over the last year, I was the only one here. And a little up the Burnside Street from the museum is this small economic community. We try to support each other, and various people in this complex have contributed to building intent. So I think taking all of the assets of the Burnside Street business community and the support from the state and the attributes that they can bring, really this boat wouldn't have happened anywhere else. And it was really a unique set of not just physical opportunities like leasing this and working with Halsey and his partner, but also the assets of the principles and the business opportunities that are available on Burnside Street in Rhode Island, and I think uniquely in the United States. Just a couple of thoughts about the building of intent and the assets that were utilized to build it. I'm really the guy that just turns the screws. The design, the details, there really isn't anything that I did that I didn't learn from somebody else, and learn in a way that wasn't just here's how to do it, but you know, here's how to live and do a good job and proceed with building the best boats you possibly can. And those are the business principles that I have that I want to build into our boats. And working with Halsey and his partner Adam was just the perfect set of bits to bring to bear. So that's how the boat got here. And it got here without any sense of reservation on my part about, you know, being able to do it. I don't think I had a day in the shop that wasn't fully comfortable that the boat would get to this point. And even as improbable as it is to, you know, set up a new business and build a boat that hadn't been built before, to me it was just, oh yeah, we can do it. And the reason we can do it is nobody said no, and everybody said, oh yeah, here's how you can do it. I'd like to mention how special it is to have taken on a crew when needed, and Halsey has seen them in action. I think Adam took great joy in seeing me run around one day rather than looking sort of lethargic and old and figuring out what to do next. Also, this is a big adventure for you know, for my family. This is something that we thought was an excellent opportunity to do with our resources and our home here. And I certainly have to thank them for bearing up over the past year to see that this gets done. I've been asked a number of times about the name of the boat, Intent. And I guess intent could be sort of loaded. It could mean a lot of different things. You know, the fact that this business is here with the intent of building business and building boats and making money is one aspect, but really doesn't have much to do with the real intent of this boat, which my grandson reminded me of. And I'd like to say that the genesis of the name Intent is all about Nathaniel Herreshoff's carving the model in his 81st year. And I can't help but think, sitting up in Love Rocks, he's carving this model. I don't think his mind was on how many would get built. I don't think his mind was on who he was going to sell it to. I think his mind was more on, boy, are my kids going to love sailing this boat. So the name of the boat is Intent, just because it's intended to be sailed and sailed by Halsey. Very special. So this boat was, I'm sure, carved with your family in mind and yourself, and I think maybe this might be the first boat you sail that you haven't sailed before in quite a while. So, Halsey, here's your boat.
Brother Nat is here, right over here back, and he and I hear a lot about the old family. And I know when the partnership began between J.B. Herreshoff and Nat Herreshoff back in the 1800s, their view was that they would build the best possible product. And that if they did that, the world would be the path to their door, like a better mousetrap. And that's really what they did. And all through my grandfather's notes, there's this subtle indication that he's just always trying to do things right. And the company was that way. And you know, during the years when they were so active building boats down the waterfront and in these shops, Nat Herreshoff would go around all the shops every morning. He took a little stubby pencil, this big, and he would talk to a foreman and say he'd like to change this thing a little bit, sketch it out. And when he came back in the afternoon, it was all done. And that's sort of the way Dan works. He's very rigidly set upon doing as good a job as he can, but he's also flexible and ready to adopt a new idea and change course a little bit and make it even better. The thing that I admire the most, Dan, on this boat, is the way you fitted that wonderful Herreshoff pear-shaped shear-strake into the hull. I don't actually yet quite understand how you did it, but it just looks like it grew. It looked like it just grew right in place there. And that's a wonderful piece of teak, and the cleverness of that and the quality of everything you've done is something that we very much admire. And I think it's a great way to start these boats off.
What could be more meaningful? Thank you very much for your time.
The Bristol community, as well as the Burnside Street community, is terrific. And you all give us inspiration. The sailors and the relatives and the neighbors, all good friends. Keep coming and keep encouraging us, please.
Thank you.